Number one, we'll talk offense. They shoot. Did you do the threes?
Shoot threes. They average 27% threes.
But they average 27 attempts.
Yeah.
Not percent.
27 attempts.
Okay. Attempts. Okay. They take more. Anybody we will see.
Absolutely. Look at the Waynedale Golden Bears as a team. Thus far this season, they've taken 34 more three attempts, and they have two attempts in the season. You don't see many teams that shoot more threes than twos at this level, so you're absolutely right. Not a team that's afraid to shoot it from beyond the arc.
Waynedale shoots it 26 times a ball game outside the line, and they're led by a pair of guards who've been together a long time, veterans, and Alyssa Geiser and Odessa Miller.
Odessa Miller, the leading points per game scorer on this Waynedale offense, averages 15 a contest. Meanwhile, Alyssa Geiser averaging 13 a game. Both of them senior guards, been in this system for a while, really the focal points of this Waynedale team.
Waynedale's also a team that wants to create problems. They did that the first time against Smithville. Fourth quarter, they turned up the pressure. They're going to try and get a lot off their defense.
Yeah, and head coach Eric Nichols for the Smithies said that the pressure just kind of got to them. They just got tired, and that's what Waynedale's whole philosophy is, full court press the whole game, and eventually you're going to wear down. And in that previous matchup where Waynedale won 49-32 against the Smithies on November 30th, that's exactly what happened.
Outscored 21-3 was Smithville in the fourth quarter. They led going to the fourth quarter last time. They want to do that again. Smithville does it a different way. They're not going to press full court. They're not going to extend. But good half-court defense. They don't allow many points. Like Smithville, one of the best scoring against averages in the area.
Absolutely. A team that comes in averaging 35 points per game allowed a contest. So you're right. Both these teams do it in different ways, but both very sound defensive-oriented teams.
Smithville does not go very deep off the bench. That's why they don't extend much, but they do have that guard post opportunity. Naomi Kibes had a good senior year, and Maddie Singer missed a bunch of time with injury. She's a point guard, very key tonight.
Kibe, a team high, 17 points per game, very good rebounder as well, 6 rebounds a contest. Maddie Singer, the point guard of the team, averages 8 points per game and 3 assists. She's going to have the ball a lot in her hands. Going to be interesting to see how she attacks this Waynedale press defense.
We take a look. We mentioned the principals on each side, but obviously both ball clubs have other girls that can show up, and you don't know who might be an integral factor in this because each team is comfortable with the five they have on the floor at any time.
Yeah, exactly. I mean, you look at the last time these two teams played, Cheyenne Chupp, who averages 8 points a contest, she ended up with 14 in the previous time these two teams played. So you're right, not afraid with the girls that they have on the floor or either of these squads.
So Waynedale and Smithville here tonight from the Berkey Fieldhouse on WQKT. We'll take another break, come back. We will have the starting lineups and get ready for tip-off here at 104.5. Coming up in just a moment.
Okay, four again, please. Thank you.
Insurance lines. Call them at 330-674-9091 or go online at HoburnInsurance.com. First, taking a look at the Waynedale Golden Bears, led by Rick Geiser. Enter this one, a record of 11-2, 6-1 in the WCAL. Starting lineups go like this. A 5'7 senior guard, Alyssa Geiser, averaging 13 points a contest. A 5'7 senior guard, Odessa Miller, averaging a team-high 15 points per game. Cheyenne Chupp, the 6-foot senior forward, averaging 8 points a contest. A 5'7 senior guard, McKenna Bainey, who averages 8 points a game. Rounding out the starting five for the Golden Bears will be Kylie Geiser, a 5'7 sophomore guard, who averages 4 points a game. Meanwhile, looking at the hosting Smithville Smithies, led by Eric Nichols, coming with this one, a record of 8-5, 5-2 in the WCAL. Starting lineups go like this. A 5'9 junior guard, Maddie Singer, who averages 8 points and a team-high 3 assists a contest. A 6-foot senior forward, Naomi Kibe, who averages a team-high 17 points a game. A 5'11 senior forward, Audrey Seidel, who averages 3 points a game. Allie Wickens, the 5'9 junior guard, who averages 7 points a game. And rounding out the starting five for the Smithies is a 5'10 senior guard, Cammie Wickens, who averages 9 points a contest. Those are the starting five for each squad, brought to you by your friends at Hoburn Insurance in Millersburg.
Well, a big ball game for each. Waynedale trying to stay one back, and Smithville trying to stay two. Smithville needs some help regardless. They get Chippewa at home next Thursday, but they need someone else to knock off the Lady Chips. Maybe it's Waynedale on the line. Waynedale will get one more crack at Chippewa, the final game of the regular season on February 15th. Last year, everybody beat each other and went 1-1. That's how they finished in a 3-way tie. And all, of course, are in the same district. as it turns out. It doesn't mean they're going to play each other because things have changed this year. You can go any one of four district sites when seeding comes out, so they might all avoid each other. Last year, that didn't happen. Chippewa beat Waynedale up at North Ridgeville, and Smithville, meanwhile, lost to Warrensville Heights in the Worcester District. Player of the ball game at the end of tonight's game, brought to you by Germain Honda of College Hills in Worcester. Everything you're looking for, new cars with all the bells and whistles, reliable used cars at affordable prices. Waynedale, the road, brown uniforms with the gold numbers and letters and white trim. Smithville and the home whites with the black and the green, and ball in the air. Tap control by Smithville. Singer up top with the basketball against the Waynedale straight man. High on the left side to Cammie Wickens. Lobs to Kybe at the top of the key. Looking high, low, trying to post up Singer, not open. Kybe drives down, laid it up on the run. Glass rim, missed it. And the rebound, Kylie Geiser. Geiser into the forecourt on the left sideline. Circles on the wing and back up top. Odessa Miller at the right point. Guarded by Kybe up top. It's an unusual matchup. Kybe the post will guard Miller up top a lot. Foul line, back up front. Bainey with it right at the key. Miller's first three, right wing off the rim. And the rebound controlled by Cammie Wickens of Smithville. Wickens into the forecourt to Singer. And Miller tracks her right in the middle of the floor. Over to the right sideline, top of the key to Kybe. She turns, drives down low on the left, kicked into the wing. Seidel's open three and got it from the baseline. Audrey Seidel gets the opening triple in the first points of the night. Waynedale pushes Geiser to the left wing. That's Kylie. Kylie, the sophomore. Alyssa, the senior. Up top with it. And basketball to Miller. Top of the key over a screen, left wing. Down low with a left-hand layup, no good. Rebound fought for loose and picked up by Alyssa Geiser. Geiser with the basketball back on the right wing to Bainey. Bainey drives baseline, muscles down low. Got it blocked by Seidel and out of bounds. Good help defense. Waynedale will keep. 6:31 in the opening quarter, 3-0 Smithville. And Alyssa Geiser will throw in baseline to the right. She looks, waits, and finally will lob up top to Cheyenne Chupp. Down low, high low to Bainey, who turns, puts it up, but no good. Cammie Wickens the board, and we'll bring it ahead for Smithville. Wickens into the forecourt up top, and bouncing Kybe near the high post. Facing up, looking, and handing off. Down low, Singer to the hole, laid it up and in. Good little handoff, and Singer makes it 5-0 Smithville. Into the forecourt on the right wing is Alyssa Geiser. Geiser skipped across court. Kylie Geiser left baseline. Drives back on the right wing to Alyssa. Her three went up. No good over the hoop. Rebound loose on the deck. And on the ground is Kybe, and she's going to get tied up. And on the arrow, it'll stay with Waynedale.
Tough start for Waynedale offensively. 0 of 5 to start this one and 0 of 2 from beyond the arc.
So Waynedale will keep. Don't forget to trust Downs Construction for your big remodeling project. Don Downs, owner. Thanks all veterans for their service and wishes the best of luck to everyone for the rest of the year. Downs Construction at 330-828-8145. Geiser, top of the key, fires and hits a three. Alyssa Geiser gets Waynedale on the board. Her 26th three-pointer of the year. 5-3 Smithville, 5:40 in the opening quarter. Cammie Wickens to the forecourt on the left wing to Seidel. Seidel put it on the deck, drove baseline, skipped it cross court. The ball, however, hit the rim, but bounced to Cammie Wickens, who drives, turns, and gets fouled going to the hole. Alyssa Geiser's foul will put Wickens on the line for the night's first foul shots.
Smithy's being very aggressive. A lot of the action that they're running on the offensive side, trying to attack the offensive glass. Wickens drove hard there and got fouled in the act of shooting.
Smithville is a team 65% from the line. Coming in, Wickens. One of three seniors in the lineup. Puts the first free throw up and in.
61% free throw shooter coming into this contest.
Georgia Persinger on the floor for the first time for Waynedale. Persinger had 8 points off the bench. Key in the first go-round. She averages 3.5. So we'll lace up a sneaker on the Waynedale side before we get going again. This the first game in the second rack of the Wayne County Athletic League in a 14-game league schedule. Waynedale 6-1, Smithville 5-2. Wickens hit them both. And Smithville up 7-3 early. Into the forecourt comes Miller. Miller up top of the basketball, guarded by Kimmy Wickens. And Wickens knocked it loose. Miller got it back on the left wing. Top of the key now to Persinger. Alyssa Geiser on the right sideline, and she's guarded by Singer. That's a good matchup. Kylie Geiser on the right wing in front of the Smithville bench. Drives baseline, kicked it behind her. Open Bainey, three up and in from downtown. McKenna Bainey stepped outside and drilled a three, and it's 7-6 Smithville. Mentioned Waynedale, they've shot more threes than twos. 52% of their field goal attempts are threes. Reach-in foul is going to be on Kylie Geiser as the pass went to Kybe at the foul line. Now, the percentage is not great for Waynedale, 27%, but when you shoot such a high volume, you don't have to make, half of them going up. If they go 8 for 25, that's a good number. Kybe left wing, her three up and in. So we've had four made threes in the opening quarter. First basket for Naomi Kybe. 10-6 in favor of Smithville. And a reach-in foul up top. Wickens a little too close with a ham check. And we'll pick up the first Smithville foul of the ball game on Kimmy Wickens.
Smithy's offensively, three straight made buckets, two of them being made threes thus far in the ball game, 3 of 4 from the field.
So Geiser will throw in. Alyssa on the far sideline. Waynedale fell in the district final last year to Chippewa in the rubber match of those meetings. And, of course, Chip all the way to the state championship game. Adessa Miller left wing, her three, went off the back of the rim, rebound tapped and controlled by Chupp. Back out top, Persinger with the basketball. And Miller will start in the middle of the floor. 4-10 opening quarter, 10-6 Smithville. Chupp top of the key with it. And over on the right to Persinger. Persinger up front needs help and gave it off to Alyssa Geiser. Middle of the floor, way up top in the green S here at Smithville. Kylie Geiser high on the left with it. And Waynedale having trouble really get going in their offense this trip. Alyssa Geiser up top between the circles. And on the left now to Kylie Geiser. Closely guarded by Leah Kybe, who's checked in. Back up front to Chupp, middle of the floor. Chupp angles over to the right wing, stops and hands to Alyssa Geiser. And her three went airborne and good. Doesn't need a whole lot of room. Second three for Geiser, 10-9 Smithville. 3:25 to go in the opening quarter. Back the other way comes Singer. Singer across the timeline of the middle of the floor. Put it on the deck, guarded by Adessa Miller. High on the right side to Wickens. Wickens up top between the circles. Now to the right elbow. Behind her to Leah Kybe. She went baseline, got trapped under the hoop, kicked it on the wing to Kimmy Wickens. Wickens baseline, back out top. Leah Kybe's three up and in from downtown. Six threes in a quarter, and Smithville's up 13-9, three each way. Into the forecourt, Miller. Miller over to the left wing, back up top. Picked up on the switch by Naomi Kybe. 2:40 to go in the opening quarter. Alyssa Geiser, top of the key to Kylie Geiser. Over to the left sideline to Miller. Miller drives into the middle, right wing kick, and the three put up by Persinger, no good. Rebound loose, hit the deck, scramble, and we're going to get a held ball. On the alternating arrow, this time it goes back over to Smithville. .229 to go in the opening quarter, 13-9 in favor of Smithville. Three threes by Waynedale, their field goals. Smithville's four field goals, they have three triples as well. And Waynedale will now pick up in the full court. Straight man. And Kybe helping out against the press across the timeline in the middle of the floor. Kirsten Ross has also checked in for Smithville in the opening quarter. Kybe down low, all the way to the hole, put it up and in off the glass. Five for Smithville's Kybe, and they lead 15-9. Alyssa Geiser the way, right wing, pulls up, long three, front rim, missed this one. Rebound, bounces around, went to Chupp. Chupp on the wing, but nobody there on the outlet pass, and the ball is turned over. And we'll go back over to Smithville.
We talk about Waynedale, a team that likes to shoot threes. 11 attempts from the field, 8 of them beyond the arc. They're 3 of 8 from beyond the three-point line.
Smithville themselves doesn't shoot a lot of threes.
Not a lot of threes taken thus far in the game. 3 of 3 shooting from the field, 5 of 6.
3 of 3 from 3, that's huge for Eric Nichols' ball club, who's 30% coming in. Wickens out front, got it knocked loose, but Geiser couldn't handle it as it rolled over the sideline. Well, since 1951, Sterling Farm Equipment, proudly serving the needs of Ohio's farming communities. Their equipment speaks for itself. Great selections of new and used Kubota, Cub Cadet, Case IH tractors, mowers, farm equipment, and more online, sterlingfarmstore.com. 150 in the opening quarter, Smithville 15-9 on Waynedale. Into the four-court singer, they double her on the wing to Kemi Wickens. Up top to Seidel. Seidel on the handle to Kybe on the weave up front. Wickens high in the right wing, still with a dribble, crosses over left wing Seidel. She looks, put it on the deck, reverses, and baseline and a whistle. And they're going to call a traveling call on Smithville. So a turnover on the Smithies.
That's going to be the first turnover of the ball game thus far.
125 in the opening quarter, 15-9, Smithville the edge. Miller into the forecourt. And high on the left side, Kylie Geiser on the wing. Around a screen, Alyssa Geiser up front with Singer trailing. Geiser onto the floor, step back, long three, off the rim, no good. The rebound, however, controlled by Bainey and stumbled inside and lost the dribble. Turnover Waynedale back to Smithville as Kemi Wickens races up the right sideline. Wickens into the forecourt to Singer with 55 seconds to go in the opening period. Smithville by six. Wickens drives down low to the hoop, put it up on the run, glass, rim it in. She's got four, an early timeout by Waynedale with 45 seconds to go in the opening period. Smithville out to a 17-9 lead. Back in a moment.
Are you worried your savings won't last your lifetime? Star Strategies can help with a common sense financial plan that doesn't lose to market downturns. Call 330-345-5207. That's 330-345-5207 or on the web at starstrategies.com. Star Strategies will make your money work smarter, earn more, and last a whole lot longer. Remember when life was simpler? We do. At Star Strategies, we keep things simple by explaining financial strategies in an easy-to-understand manner to help you prepare for your road ahead.
Worcester Orthopedic and Sports Medicine Center, a tradition of innovative care close to home. Joint treatment, sports injuries, physical therapy, and a lot more. They have what you need to get you up and moving with offices in Worcester, Orville, and Millersburg. 17-9 Smithville, 45 seconds to go in the opening quarter. Rick Geiser didn't want to wait for the quarter break. Wanted a timeout right there. And down the floor will come Miller for Waynedale. Into the forecourt, Miller up top, over a screen to the right wing, back out front. Chup swings on the left to Kylie Geiser. Top of the key to Miller. Miller over a screen to the right wing, bumped into and fouled by Seidel. She picks up her first and the team's second with 29 seconds to go here in the opening quarter. So Wickens for Seidel, that's Kemi. Two of them on the floor. We have two Kybes, two Wickens, and two Geisers out there tonight. Down low, Chup turns, high off the glass, no good. And Kybe had the rebound taken away at a foul call. Good job inside by McKenna Bainey. Kybe had the initial board, but Bainey stole it and went back up and was rewarded with a foul call, and she'll shoot two. Bainey, a basket for three, averages eight with 24 seconds to go in the opening quarter. And the first foul shot is up and in. Waynedale is a team, very good foul shooting team. 71%, due in large part. Odessa Miller's 85%. Alyssa Geiser's 73%. Those are the two girls that take most of the free throws anyway. Second free throw, no good. And rebounded by Allie Wickens. Wickens lobs forecourt to Naomi Codd. 15 seconds in the quarter. Out top with it is Leah Codd. Back to Singer. Singer backs it up with 10. On the floor, over a screen to the right wing. Singer drives, stop, give it to Leah Kybe with 5. Out front, Kemi Wickens unloads a 3. Off the rim, no good. And that's going to be the opening quarter. We played one here at Smithville. Home team leads Waynedale 17-10 here on WQKT.
Germain Honda of College Hills offers three different levels of Honda Certified Protection now. Honda True Certified Plus, Honda Certified, and new Honda True Used. These are Hondas that go back 10 model years with unlimited miles at a very affordable price, below $15,000 in some cases. All three levels provide the assurance and peace of mind that you are buying a high-quality, reliable Honda. View our inventory at germainhondaofcollegehills.com or call 330-345-5200.
Hey, it's Brooke from National Design Mart. Dreaming of updating your home with new flooring, countertops, and cabinets? Invest your tax return at National Design Mart with great offers like Triumph Timeless Beauty LVP with four colors in stock for only $369 a square foot and our popular granite and quartz You Pick 2 offer. Stop in our Medina or Worcester location or visit us at nationaldesignmart.com for details.
National Design Mart, your design superstore.
Back here at the Wilbur Berkey Fieldhouse, one quarter in the books here. Smithville leads Waynedale 17-10. For the Smithies, 6 of 8 from the field, 75%. 3 of 4 from beyond the arc, also 75%, and 2 of 2 from the free throw line. The Golden Bears, meanwhile, 3 of 13 from the field, 23%. 3 of 9 from the three-point line, 33%, and 1 of 2 from the free throw line. 5 rebounds for Waynedale, 4 for Smithville, 2 turnovers for Smithville, 1 for Waynedale.
So it will be Waynedale ball to begin the second quarter. Waynedale's three field goals, all threes, as you mentioned. And Smithville makes on average of 4 threes a game. They had 3 in the opening quarter. Odessa Miller up top, give it to Melissa Geiser. She's got 6 of the 10. Back to Miller on the left wing, drives into the corner. Kylie Geiser's 3 off the front rim. And the rebound out of the pile comes Allie Wickens. Give it off to Kybe, and then she got tied up. The arrow will keep it on the Smithville side of the floor. Well, tomorrow night, we're back in the Ohio Cardinal Conference boys basketball. Ashland comes to Worcester, hopefully weather permitting. I know we're going to get some storms late tonight, tomorrow. Hopefully won't factor in your Friday night hoops across the area. Singer into the forecourt for Smithville. Wickens trapped on the sideline and has to bounce it off the leg of Alyssa Geiser to avoid the turnover, and did so. So the Smithies will throw in across the way. And they lob into the backcourt. Singer with it. Singer high on the right side. Hands to Kimmy Wickens up top. Wickens turns. Backdoor cut for Singer. She had to dive on the ground to get it. And we're going to have a held ball. And that's going to result in a turnover. And this one against Smithville. So Waynedale basketball, 7:15 to go in the opening half. 17-10, Smithville at home here over the Bears. Waynedale ball on the right wing is Chubb. Top of the key to Kylie Geiser on the floor. Drives down low. The left-hand layup is good off the glass. First two for Kylie Geiser. 17-12, Smithville. Singer back the other way to the forecourt. Singer up top of the basketball. One-on-one. Picked up by Bainey, dribbles to the right wing, the shot off the glass and in. Falling away, a good hoop by Singer, her second field goal. Quickly, Miller into the forecourt. Alyssa Geiser's long right wing three off the back of the iron. Miller rebounds on the left sideline for Waynedale. And will drive inside, nowhere to go, and she's going to be called for a travel. Good job on the Smithville double team to cause the Waynedale turnover.
Second turnover of the game thus far for Waynedale. Smithville, meanwhile, 3 turnovers, only 1 here in this quarter.
Waynedale only turned it over 12 times. I talked to Eric Nichols, and he said, honestly, if we can keep it around 15, 16, that would be good because of Waynedale's press. He really respects it. So good so far for Smithville, and they're up 7. Cammy Wickens into the forecourt to the right wing, and a bumping foul on Miller. So Miller's first will be the opening foul of the quarter on Waynedale. 19-12, the Smithville lead. Seidel gets the throw in, back to Wickens. Wickens up top of the basketball. Pivots, turns, and got it knocked loose by Miller and out of bounds. But don't forget All Seasons Dumpster Rental, specializing in roll-off dumpsters for household and construction, serving Wayne County and surrounding areas. All Seasons Dumpster Rental. You pitch it, we ditch it. Smithville ball up top. Wickens, who does a lot of ball handling to help out Singer on the left sideline. Singer's off the bench right now, getting a rare break, so Wickens runs the point. Up top with it. Top of the key to the right wing, drives, and another bumping foul. And Odessa Miller just picked up her second. So that might be an early concern for Brett Geiser on the Waynedale bench. Quickly, Singer back in. And Geiser will trust his point guard and senior and keep her on the floor with 2 fouls early in the second quarter. Inbounds up top, Allie Wickens. And high on the left is Kybe. Singer on the left wing. Outside the three-point line. Out top, Cammy Wickens. Foul line, right of the key. Drives inside, up, in, and fouled. So she's got six. And that foul's on Alyssa Geiser. And she just got her second. So some foul concerns for the Bears here in the opening half.
And I couldn't ask for a better start if you're head coach Eric Nichols for the Smithies. 8 of 10 from the field, 80%.
Yeah, I would say so. Foul shot good. 7 for Cammy Wickens. And it's a 10-point lead, Smithville, early in the second quarter at 5:45. Back the other way comes Miller. Miller across the timeline, top of the key to the right wing. Double team, back out front. Swing at the Kylie Geiser on the left. Alyssa Geiser up front. At the right point with the basketball. Still dribbling up top. Swings it around the horn on the left to Kylie Geiser. Chop in the middle of the floor with it. Yeah, down the handoff, Alyssa Geiser, top of the key. Seidel picks her up on the switch, the pass down low. Good catch by Chupp, and she got fouled, putting it up inside on the low block. And Cheyenne Chupp will shoot a pair for Waynedale with 5:10 to go in the second quarter.
They're going to get Allie Wickens on the foul there, and just a nice find there by Geiser to find Chupp right underneath the basket. Got fouled on the act of shooting, going up with the right hand.
Foul shot up and in. Chupp averaging 7.5 per ball game. First point of the evening. Smithville by 9 early here in the second quarter. Second foul shot, front rim, and it went in. Eric Nichols tried to keep his team fresh. Mentioned he'll play 7, that's about it. But the starters log most of the minutes. Naomi Kybe with a quick rest, she's back in. And Singer on the run. Waynedale's really not gone full court zone trap at all. Mostly just man-to-man at this point. Out top with it, Leah Kybe, skips it cross court. Top of the key now. And Waynedale showing a little zone offensively for the first time. Defensively, I should say, I beg your pardon. Up top, the three, in and out by Singer, and rebounded by Chupp. And stolen away down low, shot put up no good by Cammy Wickens, and Chupp got another rebound. So the Waynedale turnover does not hurt into the forecourt for the Bears. Up top with it is Bainey. And Miller will come and get it and start the offense. Miller up top over to the left wing into the corner. Kylie Geiser, baseline, three, front rim and off. And the rebound, Bainey. Her pass down low, Alyssa Geiser on the low block. Stops, fires, short jumper, but off the back rim. Rebound tapped into the corner and out of bounds, and will stay with Waynedale. So Waynedale getting extra opportunities, but struggling from the floor here in the opening half.
8 rebounds thus far, 5 of them on the offensive glass, and this one just not a lot of capitalizing on these second chances are the Golden Bears.
4:15 to go here in the second quarter, 22-14 Smithville. Bainey with a basketball near the foul line, back to the hoop. And now we'll dribble up front. Put it on the floor, left of the key, and got fouled going to the hole. They're going to say she was in shooting mode. And McKenna Bainey will shoot a pair. That foul's going to be caught on Audrey Seidel, her second for Smithville with 4:03 to go by the half. Waynedale 3 of 4 from the line in the opening half, and Bainey's 1 of 2.
Bainey on the season, a 64% free throw shooter. And earlier today, 1 of 2 earlier in the first quarter.
Line to the right, the foul shot is up and in. Well, if you can't find new, renew your home with the Apple Creek Banking Company's renovation rate special. Minimal out-of-pocket expense. Call today for their low rates. Member FDIC, equal housing lender. I think Bainey got cut right around the right eyebrow during that collision. Maybe there's a concern about that. And if there's any kind of blood draw or anything, they'll take care of that. She looks okay, but if you got a little cut, maybe a bandage on that. So why don't we take a timeout as they attend to the Waynedale senior. 4:03 to go, second quarter. 22-15, Smithville, back in a moment.
When quality matters, trust the experts at Hallmark Home Solutions. Right now, get 0% interest and zero down when you enhance your home's curb appeal with a beautiful new entryway from Hallmark. Call now for a free estimate. Hallmark Home Solutions. When quality matters, trust the experts at Hallmark Home Solutions. Right now, get 0% interest and zero down on your choice of high-quality, energy-efficient vinyl, wood, and fiberglass windows from Hallmark. Call now for a free estimate. Hallmark Home Solutions.
Well, free throw missed as Persinger shot the foul shot. Guys, who got a quick rebound and a three up, but missed that. That's what you missed. Smithville ball the other way. Waynedale in the zone. Wickens on the right wing. Mid-range jumper up and in right of the key. Nice opening half for Kenny Wickens, who has nine. That's the Smithville lead as Alyssa Geiser is down the floor with 3:30 in the second. Up top with it is Miller. Miller on the floor to the right wing to Geiser on the sideline. Geiser flips up front to Chupp. And back on the right wing. Geiser top of the key, the pick and roll to Chupp. Knocked loose and stolen away. Good hands by Allie Wickens to deflect that. And the Waynedale turnover to Smithville with 3:05 to go in the opening quarter. Allie Wickens high on the left side. And out top. Singer in the middle of the floor gives to Leah Cobb on the right wing. She skips across court to Naomi Cobb. Kami Wickens over to the right sideline to Singer. Singer backs it up. Smithville can be delivered if they want. Up nine with 2:40 to go in the half. High on the left side, Allie Wickens. Top of the key to Kybe. She spins, goes right to the hole, put it up, rim glassing off, and chopped the rebound. Down the floor comes Kylie Geiser. Geiser into the forecourt with 2:25 in the half. Waynedale just one field goal in the second quarter and only four in this opening half. Foul line turning his Chupp over to the right wing. Miller, top of the key to Geiser. Geiser hesitation, got inside the floater with the left hand, in and out. Rebound loose on the deck and rolled around. Geiser got it back, but then got it knocked loose. And Kami Wickens comes up with a basketball. 2 minutes and a half and a timeout, Smithville. They lead Waynedale 24-15 here at the Berkey Fieldhouse. Back in a moment.
Get your vehicle back on the road smooth and problem-free with Village Motors Collision Center. Hi, this is Deke Miller, and our Collision Center works on all makes and models and has available deductible assistance, along with loaner and rental vehicles available for your use, complimentary oil change packages, not to mention that we are the preferred repair shop for most insurance companies. Ask us about our cleanup packages with four great packages from basic to premium by appointment only starting at $19.95. For collision repair, make your first stop at Village Motors in Millersburg.
In front here at home, 24-15 over Waynedale.
Waynedale struggling thus far in this quarter and in this ball game. 3 of 13 in the first quarter. They're 1 of 7 in this quarter, so 4 of 20 from the field. And head coach Rick Geiser just probably not happy with the offensive execution.
Getting decent looks, it would appear, and getting extra chances, but nothing going down. Smithville, after a hot first quarter, has cooled off themselves here in the second. They led 17-10 after a period. Up top with it is Naomi Kybe. Top of the key to Singer. Alone, the three in the air, rimming off, and the rebound controlled by Miller. Miller into the forecourt, the outlet pass. Behind Beanie, but a good catch. Out front, Persinger's three, went up front rim, no good. And Kylie Geiser tracked down the rebound and got fouled. So Waynedale again, offensive rebounds. They've done a great job there. But those have not translated into second chance points.
Seven offensive boards in this half.
1:34 to play in the half, 24-15, Smithville. And throwing in Kylie Geiser, baseline to the right. Lobbing up top to Melissa Geiser. On the floor, guarded by Singer, left of the key. Spins into the middle, puts up a tough shot, and gets fouled. So Singer's foul will be her second in the half. And Alyssa Geiser to the line to shoot a pair for Waynedale. Geiser was 6 on a pair of threes, 73% free throw shooter. And the first one rattles in and out. Waynedale from the foul line has hit 3 out of 5 in this quarter. They're 4 for 7 for the ball game. Geiser's second one airborne. Back rim, no good. Rebound loose. Kai fumbled it away. Maney got it knocked loose, and now four girls on the ground. And on the held ball, it goes back over to Smithville. 1:23 in the half. 24-15. We've been stuck on that for a while here in the second quarter. Alyssa Geiser out, maybe to protect her, with two fouls. Odessa Miller on the floor with two. They both played most of the second quarter with them. Up top is Allie Wickens, on the right to Singer. Singer with the basketball, top of the key to the foul line. Left of the key, got inside, put it up, but missed it. Rebound tapped and out of bounds, and will go where? Touch last by Waynedale, so Smithville will keep. And Alyssa Geiser's rest was about 4 seconds, so she's right back. Waynedale to trigger baseline to the right. Lobbing in, Kaiba the right elbow. Turns, faces up, drive, doubled, and threw it away. Into the key, stolen by Alyssa Geiser. Racing down the floor to the right wing. Geiser on the three-point line. Hesitation with baseline. Kicked into the wing. Tipped by Singer and intercepted by Cammie Wickens. Turnover Waynedale. Six of the ball game on the Bears. 35 seconds to go in the half. Smithville's up nine. Basketball up top and on the right wing, and Smithville throws it away. A little impatient, and a turnover gives it right back to the Waynedale Golden Bears with 29 seconds.
Mentioned Waynedale with six turnovers. Smithville, that's their sixth turnover of the ballgame as well.
In this second quarter, 7-5. That's been it scoring-wise. Smithville with the edge. Miller into the forecourt. High on the right side to Alyssa Geiser. Geiser above the three-point line. 15 seconds to go in the half. Way up front to Miller. Miller going to stand and hold with 10. And on the right wing, hand it off to Chupp. 6 seconds. Got to do something. Lobs up top. Alyssa Geiser, long three, went up off the rim. Rebound, Nomi Kaib. And that's going to be the half. Two quarters complete here at the Berkey Fieldhouse. And at the half, it is Smithville 24. Waynedale 15 in girls basketball. Back into the studio. Jeremy's got a quick halftime news break. And it's coming up after this.
3 of 6 beyond the arc, which is 50%, and a perfect 3 of 3 from the free throw line. They were led by Cammie Wickens in the first half with 9 points, 5 points for Naomi Kibe, 4 from Addie Singer, and 3 apiece for Audrey Seidel and Leah Kibe. Meanwhile, looking at the Waynedale Golden Bears as a team, 4 of 22 shooting, 18%, 3 of 15 from 3-point range, 20%, and 4 of 8 from the free throw line, which is 50%. Only 4 Golden Bears scored. They were led by Alyssa Geiser with 6, 5 points for McKenna Bainey, and 2 apiece for Cheyenne Chupp and Kylie Geiser. Rebounding battle, Golden Bears winning the rebounding battle, 13-8 versus the Smithies. The Golden Bears also 8 offensive rebounds. Turnovers, meanwhile, both teams with 6 turnovers. It all adds up to a 24-15 Smithville lead here at the Wilbur Berkey Fieldhouse halftime. And your halftime stats are brought to you by 89 Homes, your true custom home builder, offering a wide selection of floor plans. You can also customize your own. Bring your ideas to 89 Homes, Route 30 and 89 in Jeromesville, 89homes.com or on Facebook. We'll take another quick break, and Mike Breckenridge will join me for second half action here from the Wilbur Berkey Fieldhouse right after this here on 104.5 WQKT.
The employees at Holmes Wayne Electric Cooperative work hard and wear many hats at the cooperative. But that dedication goes beyond providing power to keep the lights on. They are also very active in their communities. Some volunteer at their local church, others are coaching youth, and some give back through working for their township or a community board. So what makes the cooperative different? We focus on people. Holmes Wayne Electric, always here for our members, always here for our community.
Germain Honda of College Hills offers 3 different levels of Honda Certified Protection now. Honda True Certified Plus, Honda Certified, and new Honda True Used. These are Hondas that go back 10 model years with unlimited miles at a very affordable price, below $15,000 in some cases. All 3 levels provide the assurance and peace of mind that you are buying a high-quality, reliable Honda. View our inventory at germainhondaofcollegehills.com or call 330-345-5200.
Triway, Doughton, Highland, Norwayne, and home team Smithville all play in this building. We'll have coverage here on QKT online and on YouTube on Friday, on Saturday. Saturday afternoon, the College of Worcester. Big game in the North Coast Athletic Conference. First place, Denison in town with a 4:15 tip on AM 960. So a lot of hoops, as usual, here on your sports leader in Worcester. Waynedale will start for the basketball. Frigid shooting for the Bears. They've had some decent looks, but boy, nothing going in.
Yeah, 4 of 22 that first half. 18%, 1 of 9 in that second quarter.
Waynedale, like it normally does, shoots more threes than twos. 3 of 15 on threes, 1 of 7 inside the arc. And immediately they go down low to Chupp, who muscles inside, got it knocked loose and out of bounds. So 24-15 Smithville as we begin the third quarter. For Smithville, it's a must win to have any hope of trying to get a piece of the league title. They're two back of Chippewa, Waynedale one back, and each will get a crack of the Lady Chips coming up. Down low again to Chupp, knocked loose and stolen away. Good steal by Allie Wickens and then got fouled, dribbling out. So turnover goes the other way. The other key on the other end of the floor, Smithville wanted to maintain control of the basketball, and they have limited turnovers. That's been a big key for them offensively.
Six turnovers in that first half of play, and you're right, Waynedale haven't gone full press like we've normally seen, and that's allowed the Smithville offense to kind of run their game and go inside and also get a lot of good shots outside.
Knocked loose by Alyssa Geiser, and then she got fouled. So a good play by Geiser creating a Smithville turnover. So she has two. Seidel two for Smithville. Meanwhile for Waynedale, Alyssa Geiser and Miller both with two, but both got them early in the second quarter and stayed right there. Up top with it is Waynedale. Chupp, top of the key, near it is Kylie Geiser. On the floor with the left hand, drives, wing kick, open. Alyssa Geiser, back rim, missed the three. Long rebound, caromed all the way under the right sideline, picked up by Cheyenne Chupp. Waynedale will go again. Top of the key, Geiser. Bears have had a lot of second chance looks, but no points. Really. Above the foul line at the right elbow. Baney will hold, handing to Alyssa Geiser. Left hand brings it up top. And over to Kylie Geiser. Dropped inside and a foul call. Baney went down, shoved from behind by Allie Wickens, who picked up her second. Well, Kitchen Town and Country, a full service, fresh and local grocer. Meat, deli, and produce, great taste starts at Kitchen Town and Country Store. So early third quarter, it remains Smithville by 9. Waynedale ball. Miller left of the key, lost it, rolled on the deck, and a whistle, and we're going to get a held ball. And all the alternating arrow, it goes back over to Smithville. So still a rugged start for Waynedale out of the gate here in the third quarter.
Eighth turnover of the game for the Waynedale Golden Bears now.
Smithville led 17-10 after a quarter. 24-15 now, early third. Wickens down low, Kaib cutting inside, up and in from the right. Naomi Kaib with 7. 9 point, went to 11 point, 26-15. Smithville leads 6-10 in the third. Alyssa Geiser on the right sideline, stopped on the baseline, needs help. And lob back up top to Miller. Miller came in averaging 15. She is scoreless at this point. Over to the left wing, and she is fouled. Naomi Kaib bumped into her and will pick up the personal foul. That'll be her second. And Kaib slow to get up. I think kind of reached in with that shoulder, jammed a little bit, but non-shooting foul, but already three fouls on Smithville who are early in the second quarter.
I was going to say three team fouls here, 6 minutes remaining in the third. Don't want to send Waynedale to the free throw line. A very good free throw shooting team, 71% on the year.
Alyssa Geiser throws in wide open. Baney on the out-of-bounds under, and Baney lays it up and in. She's got 7 to lead Waynedale. Smithville by 9 at the 5:50 mark of the third. Singer into the forecourt, up top of the basketball. Singer at the right point with it. Put it on the floor, drove right of the key, and backed it up. Singer still with the dribble. Count is on as she's over to the left wing and a bounce to Naomi Kaib. Kaib on the wheel into the middle, bounced it off her foot, stole it away. Alyssa Geiser racing into the forecourt for Waynedale. On the right wing, Miller floats a three, back rim off. Rebound loose, and it's going to be a foul call. And Kaib just picked up her third. So decision time for Eric Nichols with his star post, 3 fouls early in the third quarter. As Leah Kaib will check back in, and Naomi Kaib to the bench. With a 9-point lead, you have a little luxury to sit her at the time. 4 Smithville fouls. Less than 3 minutes into the third quarter. Bounce down low, turning, shooting. Baney missed it. Rebound tapped out of bounds. I'm going to go back over to Smithville. low-scoring game. It was that way at Waynedale the first time. Smithville led 29-28 after three. And then Waynedale blew him out in the fourth quarter. Cammie Wickens into the forecourt on the right wing. Sideline to Singer. Singer to the elbow. Spins right into a double team. Alyssa Geiser tied her up. Very good play by Geiser. And that creates the turnover on Smithville.
Ninth turnover of the ball game, third in this quarter here. As you see Waynedale kind of starting to get a little more pressure on that full court.
Faith Lenniker into the ball game for the first time. The freshman will see court. Had to play a lot more when Singer was down with an injury in the middle part of the year. So on the right sideline with it is Alyssa Geiser. 4:50 in the third. Smithville by nine. Bounce down low. Knocked loose by Allie Wickens. And a whistle. And we're going to get a Waynedale timeout before a held ball. It comes with 4:45 to play in the third. Smithville by nine. And back in a moment.
Connection, comfort, and safety. Three necessities for every stage of senior living. At Danbury Senior Living, peace of mind is a must for the senior and their family. Experience this and more at Danbury Senior Living of Worcester and Millersburg. Stop in for a tour at Glen Drive in Millersburg and Portage Road in Worcester. Or visit us at danburyseniorliving.com for more information. A leader of senior care in Wayne County for nearly a decade, let Danbury be your choice in the next step of senior living.
For all your insurance needs, working with multiple companies to get you the best rates, auto, home, business, and rental properties, check online, hubbardinsurance.com. 4:45 in the third, Smithville 26, Waynedale 17. It has really been an offensive challenged ball game. Neither team has been able to get into a groove after Smithville had the hot hand in the first quarter. Basketball knocked loose, Wickens with the steal. Cammie Wickens into the forecourt on the right wing. She has nine to lead everybody. And a good defensive play there. Out top with it is Lenniker. Middle of the floor, Allie Wickens against the Waynedale man-to-man. Cammie Wickens right at the key to the sideline. Lenniker up top with it and kicked it to Leah Kibe, top of the horn. Kibe with it on the right. And back up front to Singer. And Singer will restart the offense midway through the third quarter. We've had one field goal apiece in the period. Singer on the drive, right of the key, give it to Leah Kibe. Inside, put it up on the run, missed it. Rebound, Cammie Wickens back up, no good. Rebound fought for, and we're going to get yet another held ball. So Wickens kept it alive, and that was good enough to keep the possession with Smithville.
Talk about the offensive struggle ever since the end of that first quarter. End of the first quarter, 17-10 Smithville. Since then, it's been 9-7 Smithville.
Cammie Wickens down low, floats it up with the right hand. That's no good. Leah Kibe, I beg your pardon, Naomi Kibe, just back into the ball game, got the rebound and was fouled. So Eric Nichols will play his star with three fouls and will go to the line and shoot her first foul shots of the night with 3:49 to go in the third. Smithville 3 of 3 from the line as Kibe fires and misses. 83% on the season for her. And line to the right one more. And this one is good. 10-point Smithville lead. Nichols will pull Kibe. Maybe an offense-defense strategy, at least now, for Smithville's post. Odessa Miller back the other way. Miller into the forecourt to the top of the key. Kicks it left wing. Kylie Geiser's three is good. Her second basket. She has five. Smithville by seven. 3:30 to go in the third. Into the forecourt on the right wing is Cammie Wickens. Left hand to the foul line. Drives down low. Stopped by Miller, who knocked it loose. And on her knees, got a pass off. And the shot went up no good by Singer. Wickens rebound and got fouled. That was maybe not the prettiest possession, a lot of contact, but Wickens stuck with it and will be rewarded with a couple of foul shots.
Wickens going to the free throw line. First half, 3 of 3 was Wickens on the season, 61%.
So line to the right for the 5'10 senior who misses. The foul was on Chupp, her second. Team foul three, Waynedale here in the third period. So one more line to the right. And this one, front rim, also no good. And the rebound, Alyssa Geiser fell down, but got a pass off to Miller. The end of the forecourt, Miller. Miller top of the key with the left hand, lost the dribble, and then got it back. And will fire him a long three on the wing off the back of the rim, and the rebound, Leah Kibe. Kibe will control and find Singer. Less than three to go in the third, Smithville by seven. Singer into the forecourt, and on the left wing to Seidel. Seidel whips it cross-court, Leah Kibe on the right wing. Top of the key, Singer open, fake to three, drives into the key, fires and hits. Mid-range jumper by Singer, she has six. Waynedale by nine, Smithville by nine, and Waynedale with 2:30 in the third has Miller into the forecourt. Miller drives through the defense in an open lane to the hole and lays it up and in. First basket of the night for Odessa Miller. 7-point Smithville lead, 2:15 in the third. 29-22. Singer on the left, bouncing on the sideline to Allie Wickens. Wickens up top, and back to Singer on the right. Singer put it on the floor to the foul line and goes all the way to the hole and got it knocked loose and out of bounds. So it'll be Smithville ball with 1:58 to go in the quarter. Singer's going to get a quick rest. Naomi Kibe will check back in. Kimmy Wickens will throw in baseline left up top to Kibe. Kibe top of the key with it. Left of the key, kick to the wing to Wickens. Wickens back inside to Kibe, deflected by Chupp into the corner. Smithville has it back. Wickens top of the key. And on the right to Seidel, and a whistle and a reach-in foul on Waynedale. Team foul four in the quarter. And they're going to get McKenna Bainey for her first of the night. It was 24-15 at the half. It is 29-22 right now. Smithville's led basically the entire ball game. Hots shooting opening quarter when they led 17-10. Naomi Kibe on the baseline, turns into the middle with the left hand, puts it up, and they're going to call her for an offensive foul. Eric Nichols not at all happy about the call. And that was the danger of leaving her out there as she just picked up her fourth. So she leaves, Singer back in. So Kibe with 8 points, but on the bench with a minute 30 to go here in the third. 29-22 Smithville. Into the forecourt, Miller on the right. Miller up top of the basketball to Alyssa Geiser. Geiser on the floor to the left wing. Bainey swings to Miller on the right. Top of the key with it. Bainey drives inside, put it up on the run, and scored off the glass. Bainey with nine. Waynedale's gotten back to within five, as close as they have been since the first quarter when they trailed by seven. Kimmy Wickens, middle of the floor in the final minute of the third. Wickens, hands up top. Singer with the basketball. Singer up top with it over on the right wing. Bouncing inside, Kimmy Wickens. It deflected, went back to Singer. 40 seconds, and Wickens lost it. 2-on-1, Waynedale break. Bainey will go all the way to the hole, put it up, and good. Bainey with 11, 6 in the quarter, and Waynedale is now within three.
Three straight made buckets for the Golden Bears.
29-26, Waynedale trailing Smithville. 20 seconds of the quarter. On the right sideline, Singer dribbles through the defense. Right wing, Kibes, three, no good. And the rebound, Waynedale with 13 seconds of the quarter. Miller into the forecourt. Miller over a screen, top of the key with five. Way up top and on the left wing, trying to fire a three and does at the horn. That's off the mark. Heading to the fourth quarter at Smithville. Smithville leads Waynedale 29-26 here at WQKT.
When quality matters, trust the experts at Hallmark Home Solutions. Right now, get 0% interest and zero down when you enhance your home's curb appeal with a beautiful new entryway from Hallmark. Call now for a free estimate. Hallmark Home Solutions. When quality matters, trust the experts at Hallmark Home Solutions. Right now, get 0% interest and zero down on your choice of high-quality, energy-efficient vinyl, wood, and fiberglass windows from Hallmark. Call now for a free estimate. Hallmark Home Solutions.
3 quarters in the books here at the Wilbur Berkey Fieldhouse. The Smithville Smithies lead the Waynedale Golden Bears 29-26. For the Smithies, 11 of 22 shooting, 50%. 3 of 7 beyond the arc and 4 of 7 from the free throw line. Meanwhile, the Golden Bears, 9 of 32 from the field, 28%. 4 of 20 from deep, 20%. And 4 of 8 from the free throw line.
Waynedale ball to begin the fourth quarter. Waynedale outscored Smithville 11-5 in that quarter. They trail by 3. Trailed by double digits in the period on multiple occasions. But McKenny Bainey has led them back. Bainey with 6 of Waynedale's 11 in the quarter and has 11 to lead Waynedale. Up top, Persinger on the right wing and on the sideline to Kylie Geiser. Geiser with the ball, pass deflected and stolen away by Ellie Wickens. Wickens the steal and will bring it ahead into the forecourt. Naomi Kaib is on the floor for Smithville with 4 fouls to start this fourth quarter. She has 8, Kimmy Wickens 9, the Smithville leaders in the scoring department. Singer up top and over to the right wing. Picked up the dribble, needs some help, and a whistle. And a timeout called by Smithville. Early in the fourth quarter, they lead by 3 over Waynedale. Back in a moment.
Connection, comfort, and safety. 3 necessities for every stage of senior living. At Danbury Senior Living, peace of mind is a must for the senior and their family. Experience this and more at Danbury Senior Living of Worcester and Millersburg. Stop in for a tour at Glen Drive in Millersburg and Portage Road in Worcester. Or visit us at danburyseniorliving.com for more information. A leader of senior care in Wayne County for nearly a decade, let Danbury be your choice in the next step of senior living.
Headquartered south of Millersburg, Mack Oil Field Service offers trucking, dirt work, and general oil field service across the region. Proud to give back and support local at Mack Oil Field Service. Just underway, fourth quarter, Smithville by 3 over Waynedale, 29-26. Smithville had a 29-28 lead against Waynedale back in week one of this season and got outscored 21-3 in the fourth. Down low, pass inside, knocked loose and stolen away. Here comes Waynedale into the forecourt with Alyssa Geiser. She's got 6. That came in the first quarter. Vanessa Miller with 2. That's Waynedale's scoring leaders, but they're hanging around. Bainey high on the right to Kylie Geiser, top of the key. On the floor, drives, lays it up and in. And she's got 7. 1-point Smithville lead, 6:30 to go. Singer up top of the basketball. Singer on the floor behind her to Seidel. Seidel 3-point line, thought about it, lobbed inside, bad pass. Over the top of Wickens and the turnover. And it will go back over to Waynedale, who can lead in this ball game. 6:23 to play in the fourth. Smithville led by 7 after 1. They have never trailed after hitting 3 threes in the opening quarter. Into the forecourt is Miller. Miller up top of the basketball on the right wing. Kylie Geiser top of the key with it. And we'll back it up. Miller will come get it. Miller in the middle of the floor on the left wing. Alyssa Geiser. Up top to Kylie Geiser, looking inside. There's the bounce pass into the middle to Chupp, who turns, shoots, but missed it. Kybe with a rebound. They went right at Kybe, but didn't get the opportunity. I think got to like the play call for Waynedale. This didn't execute. Quickens into the forecourt. She picked up the dribble and is in trouble. And another timeout Smithville as they got trapped on the sideline. So 5:37 to go, Smithville will burn their third timeout, clinging to a 1-point lead on Waynedale. We're back in 60 seconds.
Hey, it's Brooke from National Design Mart. Dreaming of updating your home with new flooring, countertops, and cabinets? Invest your tax return at National Design Mart with great offers like Triumph Timeless Beauty LVP with four colors in stock for only $369 a square foot and our popular granite and quartz You Pick 2 offer. Stop in our Medina or Worcester location or visit us at nationaldesignmart.com for details.
National Design Mart, your design superstore.
Get your vehicle back on the road smooth and problem-free with Village Motors Collision Center. Hi, this is Deke Miller, and our Collision Center works on all makes and models and has available deductible assistance, along with loaner and rental vehicles available for your use, complimentary oil change packages, not to mention that we are the preferred repair shop for most insurance companies. Ask us about our cleanup packages with four great packages from basic to premium by appointment only starting at $19.95. For collision repair, make your first stop at Village Motors in Millersburg.
5:37 to go in the ballgame. Smithville 29, Waynedale 28. Critical for each. Trying to stay in contact with Chippewa, who's unbeaten in the Wayne County Athletic League. Out of a timeout, Smithville basketball. Wickens, Kybe, Naomi, along with Singer, and the other Kybe, Leah. Basketball to Allie Wickens on the left wing. Up top to Singer. Singer put it on the floor, drove inside into a double team. Nowhere to go on the left wing, Leah Kybe. Leah Kybe to the right wing. And Allie Wickens back up front. Straight man-to-man defense by Waynedale. Singer on the floor to the right wing, drives inside. Kick to the wing. Wickens, three, got it. Big basket by Allie Wickens, her first hoop of the night. And Smithville by four, 5 minutes to go.
First made three since the first quarter.
Yeah, and then we said they make four per ball game. That's their fourth. And Smithville goes zone for the first time. Left wing three, Bainey off the back of the rim. And the rebound, Allie Wickens out of the pile. 2-1-1 break. Cammie Wickens gets the bounce in. Got knocked loose. Bainey knocked it loose. No foul call. Saving the basket. 4:40 to go in the ballgame. 32-28 Smithville. Singer will throw in. Baseline right. Looks, waits, and gets it on the wing to Allie Wickens, who drives to the key, put it up on the run, glass rim, and it came out. Rebound, Chupp. Miller the other way for Waynedale with 4:30 to go. 4-point Smithville lead. And zone by Smithville. You don't see it much for the Smithies. Leah Kybe on the bottom. Naomi Kybe. All 6 feet of her with length is at the top of that zone. Kind of a 1-2-2 look. She's at the top of the key. So Waynedale moving around the perimeter. I don't know if Rick Geiser expected this, but obviously they play teams who zone them up. On the right wing with a basketball high up top, Miller swinging around the horn. Kylie Geiser on the left. Left wing, Alyssa Geiser's three, rimming off. And the rebound, Naomi Kybe. 3:45 to go in the ball game. Smithville by four with the ball. And Singer on the slow walk into the forecourt. On the bounce to Allie Wickens. Got it knocked loose. Got it back. Double team. And then threw it away. Stolen by Bainey. Tipped loose by Cammie Wickens, who can't save as it rolls over the sideline and out of bounds to Waynedale.
13 turnovers for Smithville. 10, meanwhile, for Waynedale. And you're right, the previous offensive possession for Waynedale, they just looked out of sorts. And you're right, head coach Rick Geiser didn't look like he was expecting the Smithies to go zone there.
Well, he was directing traffic from the sideline, though. So Waynedale will have to adjust to it. And I mentioned, they've seen zone by a lot of other schools, just maybe not Smithville. Miller, left wing three. That's an air ball over the hoop. And the rebound, Allie Wickens on the baseline. It got shoved out of bounds. Bainey's foul is the first foul of any kind in the fourth quarter. Eric Nichols, one of those guys, loves man-to-man. That's all he wants to play. But realizing, especially with Leah Kybe with four fouls and Waynedale targeting her, maybe one of the reasons they've shown a little zone in the fourth quarter. Into the forecourt is Singer. Singer up the left sideline through traffic all the way to the rim. And the bounce inside got knocked loose and stolen away. Chupp with the steal. 3 minutes to go. Kylie Geiser on the left wing for Waynedale, down four. up top of the basketball. Middle of the floor, Alyssa Geyser. And cross court to Miller. Miller on the wing. Bounce inside, knock loose, and Chupp controls, shoots, and scores. Cheyenne Chupp with four. Her first field goal of the night. 2-point Smithville lead with 2:35 left. Singer into the forecourt. Singer up top of the basketball. Over to the left wing. Splits the defense. Got inside. Put it up and in. Driving layup by Singer, who's got eight. And a timeout on the floor. Comes with 2:24 to go with the ball game. Smithville in front, 34-30 on Waynedale. Back in a moment.
For over 40 years, Worcester Orthopedic and Sports Medicine has provided trusted and innovative care to our community. We specialize in spine surgery, joint replacement, MRI, X-ray, physical therapy, sports injury rehabilitation, and more. Ready to serve you from three convenient locations, our staff is committed to providing individualized care so that each patient enjoys optimal results. Worcester Orthopedic and Sports Medicine, a tradition of innovative care that's close to home.
The employees at Holmes Wayne Electric Cooperative work hard and wear many hats at the cooperative. But that dedication goes beyond providing power to keep the lights on. They are also very active in their communities. Some volunteer at their local church, others are coaching youth, and some give back through working for their township or a community board. So what makes the cooperative different? We focus on people. Holmes Wayne Electric, always here for our members, always here for our community.
Remaining, they called that one. They lead by four, 34-30. Waynedale ball, 2:24 left.
For Smithville, 13 of 25 from the field, 40%, 4 of 8 from the beyond the arc, and also 4 of 7 from the free throw line. For the Golden Bears, 11 of 38 from the field, 29%, 4 of 23 from deep, 17%.
Into the forecourt, Waynedale. Smithville sits in the zone. Kylie Geyser lobbed down low. Chupp on the low block on the left. Turns into the middle. And kicked it to the top of the key. Three by Bainey is off the rim. And the rebound, Chupp. Put it back up and good. Chupp with six, four in the quarter. Again, 2-point Smithville lead. 2 minutes to go. Singer on the run into the forecourt. Singer over to the right wing. And we'll back it up. Guarded by Geyser. Sideline on the right, Kybe. Kybe skips it cross court. Intercepted. Kylie Geyser with the steal. Waynedale can tie or lead this trip with a minute 40 to go. Bainey up top and flipped it down low and knocked loose by Seidel and a held ball. Good defensive play, and that's going to be a turnover because the arrow goes right back to Smithville.
Waynedale has done a good job not turning the ball over this quarter. 11 for the game, but only 2 this quarter. They forced a lot, forced 5 turnovers for Smithville, but just bad turnover there for Waynedale. Critical possession.
A minute 30 to go in the ball game. Smithville by 2 with the ball. Keep in mind, Waynedale's only committed 1 foul. There's the second. They can afford to be aggressive. That's not a problem if they want to gamble with some steals. Bainey picked up the foul. Just the second team foul in the quarter. Smithville, by the way, has not been whistled for a foul. So they could also be aggressive if they want, except for Kybe, who's the only person on the floor with 4 fouls. Singer with a minute 20 to go has it near the timeline for Smithville. They're up 2. Singer across the timeline, up top and over on the left wing, dropped it off to Allie Wickens. Wickens brings it up top, harassed by Miller. On the weave to Cammie Wickens. She drives it to the foul line. Right of the key. Stop. Needs help. Bounce over to the wing to Naomi Kybe. Kybe on the floor. A minute to play. Up top, Smithville running clock. Allie Wickens drives inside. Kicks it to Cammie Wickens on the wing. Back up front. Now reverses on the right wing. 45 seconds. Smithville playing chaser. Waynedale's got a foul, but there it is. Chupp with a bump up top. That's team foul 3. 42 seconds to go in the ball game. 1 more to give.
Just a great possession there for the Smithies. Just draining a lot of time off the clock. Didn't see any shot that they liked, but just dwindling down that time.
Persinger on the floor for Chupp for Waynedale. 42 seconds to go. Smithville by 2. 34-32. Inbounds into the corner. Tip loose by Persinger. That's a tough inbounds pass into the corner. Big break for Smithville there. Yeah, and we'll throw in again on the sideline across the way. But this time closer to the corner. Kimmy Wickens will toss in. Trying to find someone, lobs in and chased down by Allie Wickens. Good hustle. Over to Singer, and she's slammed into by Miller. That's four fouls on Waynedale with 38 seconds to go. So see how long they might wait to get a steal before they put Smithville on the line. Smithville's up two. Third foul on Miller. Wickens to throw in again. Gets it, looks, and pitches into the backcourt to Singer. Singer waits and dribbles past Miller. Pass the double team to the right wing, and there's the foul. It comes with 32 seconds to go. 34-32 Smithville, and Maddie Singer on the line with a pair.
They got McKenna Bainey there. It's her fourth personal foul.
Singer with eight. First free throw of the night for the 5'9 junior guard. And foul shot airborne and good. Hasn't been to the line a bunch this year. Just 5 of 7 before that one. So Smithville by three, 32 seconds. Second foul shot off the back of the rim. No good. Rebound Geiser. Here comes Waynedale down three. Running into the forecourt. And here's your time. 26 seconds to go in the ball game. We'll keep it right here with Smithville up 35-32. Shop Kane & Meats for the best locally raised beef and pork. Check out their meat bundles and fresh meat display case with daily specials. All on Old Columbus Road in Worcester. Shop local. Shop Kane & Meats. Well, it has delivered between these two. Hard fought. Both teams have struggled from the floor outside of the blazing start for Smithville, who was 6-for-8 in the opening quarter with three threes and led 17-10. But after that, they've struggled, and Waynedale struggled all night from the field.
Waynedale struggled as a team, 12 of 40 from the field, 30% beyond the arc, also struggling. We talked about 4 of 23, 17%, a team that's just such a high-volume shooting team. A lot of them have not gone down tonight.
But ever dangerous is Waynedale, so how do they want to play it? Still plenty of time. They don't need a three if they get an open look, obviously. Anybody on the floor almost can shoot it, but especially Geiser and Miller would be the top contenders. But Bainey can shoot it, even Chubb. 26 seconds to go. Keep in mind, Smithville, zero fouls. Waynedale's over the limit. It'll be Waynedale ball triggering right in front of their bench. Down three. Miller with a basketball. And another timeout. I guess Smithfield was going to come out and go man. And I think that might have changed the play call for Rick Geiser, because Smithfield has been in a zone the last couple of minutes. So he saw how the alignment was, wanted a different call. Each team is now going to be left with one timeout.
And we saw that the Smithies went zone primarily, it seems, to prevent the Golden Bears from attacking Kibe. And now they go man there, and you got to be thinking, head coach Rick Geiser talking about, if they go into man, we're going to run this play, go into zone, we're going to do a different play.
Of course, the district in Division III in the Northeast, Waynedale, Chippewa, Smithville, all will be a factor. Tuslaw could be a factor. Right now, Waynedale's third in the RPI this week. Keystone and Rootstown in front of them. Chippewa's sixth. Warrensville Heights is back, they're fifth. And once again, there's four district sites, Worcester, and then three to the north and east. North Ridgeville's north, Cortland, Lakeview, and Struthers to the east. And you could go wherever you want after you're seated. So we might not see any of the locals together. We'll see how it all plays out in the next month. 26 seconds to go. Waynedale down three, inbounding. Back up top, Kylie Geiser on the right. And Smithfield back to the zone. Left wing Miller. There's the three. Off the rim. No good. Rebound tapped in and went to Allie Wickens. Wickens for Smithfield on the backcourt and fouled. Well, a little point counterpoint as Smithfield went back zone. Miller got a good look, although a deep three. And now Allie Wickens, who has really quiet but made some big plays in the fourth quarter, will go to the line with two big foul shots.
Hasn't scored a lot. Scored 9 points all in the first half, but to your point, has yet to score here in the second half.
To the line to the right, Wickens, first free throw of the night. Foul shot is no good. 15 seconds to go, 35-32, Smithville. Huge foul shot here by Wickens. 54% is the 5'9 junior. Up and good. Rolled around the rim and went in. Waynedale's got a push. Down four, 13 seconds. Miller into the forecourt, way up top of the basketball. Smithville extending the zone. Miller high on the left to Kylie Geiser, 5 seconds. Her long three went up, in and out, no good. Rebound, Chup put it back up and in, and a timeout with less than a second. 0.4 seconds. Waynedale could not get the look early, and the extra time means hope time right now. Down two, they have got to have a turnover with 0.4 on the clock unless they put a couple of more tenths. We don't have the video monitors in the replay, which I see a lot in college hoops in Division III. They are going to put 0.3 of a second back on, so 0.7. But for Smithville, really, all they need is a clean inbounds play to lock this one up.
And for Waynedale, what you need is a steal and just to throw it up as soon as you get it. Not enough time to really set your feet and get a great look. But you're right, a clean inbounds pass here more than likely will be the ball game for the Smithies.
Cheyenne Chupp, who had the stick back, she's got 6 of the 8 points for Waynedale in the quarter. But scoring for Waynedale is down. They did not want this game in the 30s. They can win it there. But score by quarters, 10-5, 11-8. For a Waynedale team that averages in the 50s. But it has just been a cold shooting night. It does happen. And Smithville's biggest supporter tonight is Chippewa. Because if it stays as it is, Chippewa's got a 2-game lead in the conference. So 36-34 Smithville. Waynedale out of timeouts. Eric Nichols does have a timeout left for Smithville. If they can't inbounds, he can call one. Or if nothing else, throw the ball down the floor and tip it. So 0.7 to go in the ball game. Allie Wickens will throw in on the backcourt. 36-34 Smithville. Trying to get a successful inbounds. Wickens to throw in. Looking. Just fires down the floor. And it's tipped. And that's going to be the horn. Smart play by Smithville. And Smithville gets a monster win at home to stay alive in the Wayne County Athletic League, knocking off one of their rivals, 36-34 here tonight at the Berkey Fieldhouse. We'll take a time. Post-game stats and story coming up next. After three and hung on down the stretch. Waynedale outscored them 8-7, but Smithville did enough to win it 36 34. Dean's got a look. Get all the numbers.
Thank you very much, Mike. Postgame stats brought to you by the Home Appliance Company in Massillon. Best in product, price, and service. Name brand appliances at great prices at Home Appliance Company in Massillon. Well, the Smithville Smithies, a 36-34 winner over Waynedale. For the Smithies, 13 of 25 at shooting, 52%. 4 of 8 from three-point range and 6 of 11 from the free throw line, which is 54%. They were tied for a team high. Cammie Wickens with 9 to go along with Maddie Singer's 9. 8 points for Naomi Kibe. 4 for Allie Wickens and 3 apiece for Audrey Seidel and Leah Kibe. Meanwhile, taking a look at the Waynedale Golden Bears as a team, 13 of 43 shooting 30%. 4 of 25 beyond the arc, which is 16%, and 4 of 8 from the free throw line. They were led by McKenna Beeney with 11, 7 points for Kylie Geyser, and 6 points apiece for Cheyenne Chupp and Alyssa Geyser, and also Odessa Miller. Quiet night, only 2 points shooting on the night. Rebounds, 18 rebounds for the Waynedale Golden Bears to Smithville's 16. How about 11 of the 18 offensive boards for Waynedale? Turnover battle, meanwhile, Smithville, 15 turnovers on the night to Waynedale's 11. It all adds up to a Smithville win, 36-34, over the Waynedale Golden Bears. Head coach Eric Nichols and the team improved to 9-5. The Golden Bears fall to a record of 11-3. Postgame stats brought to you by the Home Appliance Company in Massillon. Great brands like Whirlpool, GE, Frigidaire, and many more, all at great prices. Home Appliance Company in Massillon.
One final piece of business. Got to dole out the player of the ball game. And tough tonight in a ball game that only had 70 total points. First off for Waynedale, McKenna Beeney, Cheyenne Chupp both played well in a helper's note. Beeney with 11, Chupp with 8. That's 19 of their 34. Alyssa Geyser held to 6 and Odessa Miller 2, as you said. Huge key for the Smithville defense there. Meanwhile, on the other end of the floor, Smithville didn't get anybody to double digits. But just everybody kind of contributed tonight for Eric Nichols' ball club. Maddie Singer was consistent, good defense, ran the point with 9. Kimmy Wickens had 9, all in the first half. And Naomi Kibe battled foul trouble and had 8. So a lot of contributors across the floor.
Absolutely. I mean, like you said, Maddie Singer, you can look at Kimmy Wickens, you can look at a multitude of different players for the player of the game. Maddie Singer controlled the point, and I thought ran the offense actually fairly well.
By the way, I already wrote it down. Our Jermaine Honda of College Hills player of the ball game is indeed the point guard for Smithville, Maddie Singer. Look, 9 points. She had to spend defense most of the night either on Alyssa Geyser and Odessa Miller, and that's a load. Kimmy Wickens was right there and did yeoman things as well, but we'll give it to Singer tonight, our Jermaine Honda of College Hills player of the game. So Smithville stays alive. They get Chippewa in here next Thursday. We'll have that one on QKT as well. Waynedale's going to be rooting for Smithville next week because now they're 2 back. They hope that Smithville could beat Chippewa, and then they get the Lady Chips to end the year at their place, but they need help. Chippewa is in control of the Wayne County Athletic League right now. Thanks to Jeremy in studio. For Dean, I'm Mike here at the Berkey Fieldhouse. Final score in girls basketball tonight. It was Smithville 36 and Waynedale 34. Have a good night. Stay warm, and thanks for listening.